Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Today, this evening, I'm gonna cast this clan war between the Pro Kings and, whoopsie, looks like we are already in the game. There we are. Okay. Okay, awesome. Don't want to make any mistakes here, as we are loaded in game number one of this best of five, spawning in the bottom left position of Galactic Process Letter Edition as the Purposer, playing for Team Pro Kings. It is Claire. And the opponent spawning in the top right position in the green trunks, the Protoss player for Forge Force Gaming, it is Multi. Awesome, so we do have a PVC here. Okay, okay. Didn't cast too many of those, but I think that one's a good one. Let me just check. Yes. Okay, overlay is good. If you have any feedback, tell me in the chat, and I will fix everything which might be... which might need some fix, like volume and such. So far we have for Multi one gateway expand, as it looks like. Probe moving out for scouting, and for clear hatch, gas pool, standard openings for both of those players. And we will see how this game goes. There are some gold bases right there and here, which later on could be very important. But first of all, we need to hit that stage of the game. And I'm really interested in what Claire's gonna do. Oh, I love this. Multi doing a very good job of breaking the worker stacking here out of Claire, which is so annoying. Got the crystals now, the minerals. Crystals, low. The minerals, so can't do this anymore. But got a good scout. Was annoying as well, and saving the probe for a later scout as well, and behind that going for, of course, the cybernetics core and a second gas. Okay, so maybe with this probe he goes, no, no, he could, I mean, Multi could go for a pylon block here with the cybernetics core block, but on that map, because this space can be taken as a third as well, I highly doubt it. And there are the circlings out already, and this probe won't find any potential to block the space. Might even go down, which is a bit unfortunate, but not the biggest deal here. Ooh, and we see the Twilight Council for Multi, sys tech choice, and one adapt so far. So I'm really, ooh, nice save on the probe. Yeah, the settlings need to retreat. Before they have speed, before they don't have speed, they can't really compete with the adapt. Yeah, they could try, but it's a bit risky. Oh, the shade goes through. Okay, so Multi definitely wants to scout, as it looks like, and get out of it with the shade again. Some kind of wall off going on for Multi here. Resonating glaives, giving their adept some more speed with their attacks. And what's the tag here for Claire? So far only speedling. Ah, I see. Okay. I wonder if you will see Hydralisk and Baneling, or something else, which could be good as well. Welcome everybody to the stream, hope you enjoy the cast. A Mothership Core is out, and the Circlings finally have speed now, and try to get anything done, like even if it's just scouting, but one might die here. Yes, a second one as well. So two circlings to scout that there is a wall. I would have loved to just have an overlord there, but there are not many overlords around. Look at that, only one here to scout the third base. I would love to have a second overlord over here potentially, just to see what's going on, or maybe here. But of course there is the risk of getting spotted with observer and then sniped by stalker. Interestingly, yeah, the drone count is not that great compared to the probes outpost count. And we will see, this is not a real big attack Multi is doing, just it's not a big commitment here, but it could deal so much damage. Cancels the Shade and now needs to retreat back, but trades quite good. Nice micro on the adepts against the Circlings, losing only one so far, a second one, maybe a third one? Doesn't block it, and the Shades go through. Some of those adepts very breached. Oh, nice focus fire with the Roach there, I like that. And overall, the damage dealt is okay, I would say. It's not too bad. Yeah, okay, losing 7 adepts for it, it's okay. At least we got some scouting. And was a little bit annoying. But behind that, look at the army supply. 10 against 35, that's not much. We do, however, see a robotics facility. And the Immortal is on the way out, as well as plus one and Blink behind that as well. Okay. Oh! That weapon. Could have gone so wrong. Yeah, those Circlings don't find any opening so far. And we will see, we will see. Needs to retreat, just tries to get up. Oh, nice trap! All those Circlings will die now, and might not even get one sentry. It's so close! Ah, gets one sentry for like 16 to 20 Circlings, and got some energy out of them. Was it worth it? Probably not. Probably not. The Protoss is on. Oh, four gases so far only. That's not a lot. I would have thought Multi would go on to 6 gases ASAP. As a Protoss player, you need the gas. But instead we see a heavy gateway explosion. Adding 5 to the 3 in total are 8. 8 gates with Blink, Resonating Glaives, Warp Prism. We could see some heavy gateway attack. And so far Claire seems not prepared for it. However, there are 11 more Roaches out on the way. But the upgrades are not looking so good. Ravage are good against Force Fields, but Immortal wrecked through that. There's only one so far. No second one. Okay, so maybe Claire can hold this push. Especially if she sees it. Oh, nice Force Field there. Needs to... Oh, so many Roaches die there. But, well, I would say it was worth it for Claire. 5 Force Fields and getting a sentry for 5 Roaches. That's an okay trade, I would say. And Multi has, where's the Mothership Core? Back at home. So no recall available here for Claire. I do like the Force Fields, but... Ah, Claire goes for a counterattack? No. Okay, throwing on some vials. Needs to wait a little bit now. Some of them are on cooldown. The upgrade's still not looking really good. Oh, don't go down there, don't! Ooh, the sentries. That was risky. But I wonder, Claire is still on 3 base against a 3 base Protoss. There are some Circlings opting for a counterattack or a potential flank move, which is currently not happening. And Claire doesn't find an opening, loses an Overlord there. Gets an adapt, that's nice. Oh, losing the Overseer, that hurts. That's not too good. And yeah, Multi is boxed in. But maybe Multi can hold on here. Oh, the corrosive vials, they are huge! Wow! That was expensive, but overall I would say the army is looking better for Multi here, especially with the plus one upgrades. The plus one upgrade, singular. But there are so many Stalkers. Should I have Blink so you can micro back against the force of Claire? Oh, I like the Conclave. Clear was opting to go for. Oh, gets the War Prism, that's really good. Some huge corrosive files hit the Immortal and the army. The sentries go down. Nice Blink escape, but you just blinked into a trap. There are so many Circlings. You need to blink again. And there are more and more units coming. Multi just lost a lot in this engagement. And I don't know, Claire behind that took the 4th base, which is nice as well. It's working on the plus 2 melee attacks, which is good. Yeah, Multi lost so many expensive units, but keeps the Stalker alive. So that's at least something going on good for him now. And behind that, on that map, yeah, he's quite safe. So far, Claire did no damage. No Overlord drops, no Baneling drops, no not taking down the destructible or anything. And sure, if Claire can deny the fourth base over and over again, Claire will be in a good spot. But so far, it's still an open game. Completely open. That can happen so much. Oh, the Mothership 4 might just die now. Ah! Don't kill your own Ravager! Wow, the Mothership 4 just survived with taking no damage at all. That's impressive. The Destructible holds strong for now, going down any second. Oh, good storm on top of the Surfings and the Banelings. Some nice corrosive vials, good hits, but it's not enough. And I feel like Claire needs to transition out of the tech. Like, Claire's still on Lair tech. Eventually, Claire wants to get into Hive, which she could afford if she would take the gases on the fourth phase. But the Stalker are shipping away so good on the Ravager because there's nothing to buffer. You need some support for the Ravager, otherwise they are quite vulnerable and not as strong. Oh, losing those three Ravager is massive. That really hurts. Claire should maybe go and kill the Nexus, but it's on full retreat mode. And as a Surf, yeah. Okay, should get this. Oh! Don't move into your own corrosive files, please. Nice storms again on the army, but is it enough here? The Circling's closing in. Oh! The close, Blink. Very close. But I just think Multi can hold this. Maybe not. Huge corrosive files going down on the Archons and the Blink Stalker. It is so close, but for now Multi holds strong. And Multi has a huge bank, needs to spend it somehow. Getting upgrades, warping in more stuff, just do it, or even get a bunch of cannons, I don't know. Just do something with your money. I do like the Warp Prison play, by the way. Those adapts, they are not finding huge amount of damage here, but they are doing quite a nice job. And there's another Warp Prison as well, but the fourth base gets denied again. And if this keeps continuing like that, we can see the main base is almost mined out. He can't set a resaturate on another base. There are 16 probes not doing anything here. The natural is oversaturated as well. And Claire is looking healthy here. I would just love Claire to take some gases to eventually transition out of the current tech. But so far, Claire sticks with Ling, Bane, Ravager, which works quite nicely. So she doesn't need the gases here. Nice counterattack with the Zealots. Will it be enough? It should be enough. Oh, no cancel, but a kill. The Warp Prison is too late, but that was a good deny here. On the other side of the map, some small skirmishes are going on as well. And I think that's the fourth attempt to take this base. And Multi has such a problem. Maybe Multi should use the Warp Prison, just get a hidden sneaky ninja base to get the mining gun. Still, there is some bank left, yes, but eventually this will be bad for Multi, I feel like. Even though storms are really strong and the upgrades are looking solid so far, I just think Multi needs the space ASAP. The Warp Prism again, closing in for some warp-ins, potentially. And there's the fourth base. Might get denied again. Multi just can't defend it. He holds on, which is nice, but it's not enough. It's simply not enough. You can't win a game by just holding on if the guy who is attacking you isn't overcommitting, which Claire isn't. Claire isn't overcommitting. Yes, Claire is trading units over and over again, but Claire can do this. Look at that. The storms are really nice, but Claire just has better mining, better eco, better spending, I would say. And now Multi's bank is depleted. The Mothership Core taking some damage here, almost going down. And yeah, the space is dead again. Look at that. At least it should die. No cancel this time. So Multi barely can hold on here. Emergency pylon overcharges, but I think we just see the end of this game any second now. Multi sure will try as hard as he can, but I don't think that will be enough. Double pylon kill again. The probe survives, but does it matter? I don't think so. Multitrust needs another nexus, look at that. Oh, nice counterattack with the Zerglings closing in here, separating the army from the third base, which is so important for Multi here. But I feel like even if Multi can clear this army, it won't be enough. It simply won't. Good link, but the nexus still. Oh no, there are so many Zerglings. This has to be game. Look at the stream of Zerglings coming across the map. This is just way too much Zerg here for Multi to hold on. And I think we should see the GG any second now. There we go. G! And Claire wins this game. Nice. Very well played, Claire. Very well played. Okay, so now we are looking for the second game. Yeah, I like that at CVP. So Claire definitely played the map and the opponent. Denying the fourth base over and over again was a really smart move. And if you can manage to do this without overcommitting too hard, you can stay on layer tech quite a while, as we just saw. You don't necessarily need hive tech. And I think Claire did the right call there. If Claire would have gone into hive tech, that would have meant that she wouldn't be able to commit that hard to the aggression she just did. And then Multi might have just had an opportunity to come back into this game. So, yeah, I liked Claire's decision behind that. Not going for the hive tech and give the opportunity to Multi to come back. Okay, so the next game. I don't know exactly what map this will be for now, but I will sure know soon. There we go. Frozen Temple. Okay. So it is Frozen Temple. Nice. Very nice. Okay. So now I'm waiting for the player to come in. And then we will just ASAP start the next game. In this awesome clan war. Okay, looks like for pro kings, Terran player is gonna play, certain. Okay, nice. I really wonder who Forge Force Gaming will send in. I'm really looking forward to see the player chosen by Forge Force Gaming. I just can't remember this clan. It's so bad. I suck. I'm sorry. I always I'm always wrong. Forged Force Gaming. Forged. Not Forge Forced. Forged Force. Okay. Oh, nice. TVP. Okay. TVP should be a good one. I love TVP. On Frozen Temple, it can be really wild. So maybe we see some Cyclone play that could be interesting. Or maybe we see some one base cheese for the Protoss player. But who knows? Who knows? And here we are in the loading screen. Ooh. Okay, let me set the score properly. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to game number 2 of this clan war between Pro Kings and Forged Force Gaming. As we have spawning in the bottom right position as the green Protoss, it is Affilay. I hope that's pronounced correctly. And spawning as the teal Terran in the top left position of Frozen Temple, playing for Pro Kings, it is Certain. Going with the Rex into gas. And for Affilay we have pylon, gate, assimilator, standard openings for both players. No probe scout. Mention this. No probe scout. Normally most protoss go with the probe after the gate. So they plant down the gate and go scouting, but not this guy. He doesn't like scouting. He wants to play in the dark for now. He wants to have all the money. And now he's sending out one probe to grab a Nexus himself. Double guess! For certain, look at that! Oh wow. Okay, but now the probe goes scouting. It might just be too late. Potentially. So there is one marine factory. If the supply depot goes down right now. Oh, it's so close. It's so close. No, it's not really so close. It is close if the supply depot isn't raised. Raise the depot, raise the depot! This probe is dead. But saw the factory. Not a really good position of the from the factory. However, did Affilay click it? It could be a 3 Rex. Unlikely, but it could be. Ah, reactor. Okay, very interesting. So, I don't think we will see a Cyclone game. Play here out of certain. Interestingly, Affilay is going for a Stalker instead of an Adept. And there we have a Widowmine, more Marines. There we go. Okay, so Widowmine drop potentially into a second base, which is quite late. So this commitment needs to pay off. Certain needs to deal real damage here. If he gets 10 probes, then he will just be even, potentially? We will see. Ooh. Do we see tank, medivac, cyclone push with bunker? Then it could be an all-in. And then he needs to end the game with this push or deal crippling damage like killing the Nexus and trading away a good amount of army. For another good amount of army out of Affilay. Double gate added here, so 3 gates, 1 robo in total. And that's already really good for a Protoss player here. Because he will be able to pump out a lot of units, which he will need to defend upcoming push. And there we are. Where are the... Oh, it's really just a drop? I'm wondering. There's the Liberator, there's the tank. We just might see a Cyclone. Observer on the way. We'll see the medivac. Yeah, plenty of time to react to it. He does throw down a pylon. Oh, interesting choice to drop it there. Ah, there are the SCVs. Okay, lift the marine, don't let... Ooh, loses one marine, which can already be huge, but... nice micro now. Loses another marine there. Photon overcharge is used. Loses another marine. And there's the warp prison. Good Widowmine connection. Where's the tank? It's so late. Oh, so many marines are going down. And oof. Widowmine takes some fire there from the tank. The tank survives, that's good, but the warp prison on the way. If only the Cyclone could lock onto it. So I don't know, Affilay seems in a pretty damn good position here with the War Prism to deal a lot of damage. Cut off any reinforcements, deal crippling damage to the economy, and Certain needs his economy right now. There is nothing back at home to defend, and no warping so far. Interesting. There we are, big attack, still no warping, and yeah, the Cyclone should lock on to the Mothership Core, or maybe a pylon, maybe in the Nexus. There's one Adept being warped in, and I don't think Serpent sees it. Ah, Immortal is there, probe gets pulled, but this damage is good. The Widowmine dealing a lot of damage, not damaging the tanks. The CVs are surviving. The Liberator falls, however. And there is this one adept dealing massive damage. And pulling the SCVs against an adept with a war prism above it is not really good. Oh, nice save on the tank. So close. The SCV is not on auto repair. That's a mistake in my opinion. And yet now there is one Liberator, but four adepts. Certain is on a timer here, and I don't think that he will be able to win this. However, maybe with the tanks he can do it. He still has the bunker. The Marines are doing an okay job, but this Liberator is not enough back at home to defend. And I would say FLA is okay with losing the Nexus. He dealt so much damage, there is one tank out now, but adepts deal a lot of damage to the tank as well. Ah, see to the tank up now. That's good. But 12 SCVs. Oh, big attack here against 24. The bunker might fall, the tank might just fall. That's huge. Ah, cannot save it. The Immortal Strong needs to get into the other bunker here. Does manage to do so. But yeah, the damage is real. Oh, the Immortal just barely survives. Maybe not. All those Protoss units are so low. Yes, the Immortal survives. That's huge. And now Zerd needs to move back, evacuate. He might finally get the War Prism, but not with killing the... No! Kill it! Oh, come on! What are you doing? No! I think that is not really looking good for our Terran player here at all. There's the War Prism again. And nothing back at home to defend. The Liberator could deal massive damage, but it's spotted. Stalker warp in, and this force is so small, and there are two Immortal in this drop, and there's a free tank to grab. Another Stalker gets warped in, there's the pylon cannon as well ready. Tank gets shot down. Cyclone Liberator doesn't find any damage here. The Nexus did survive as well, and those two Immortal are just way too strong. How do you defend against this? Look at the damage they are dealing. That is so massive. The Liberator, however, is dealing a lot of damage. Oh wow, way more damage than it should get. But Immortal survive. If he would have gotten a War Prism with both Immortal inside, that would be good. But yeah, he knows he's out. GG! 1-1 in this clan war. Oh wow. But a nice attempt. A very nice attempt for this kind of build. Ha! I just ranked up to newbie level! Awesome! Whatever that means, I haven't set up Vivbot correctly, so yeah, something is just running in the background, but whatever. Okay, so it is 1-1. Oh wow. So potentially we might go into game number 5. You're still it's still a bit far away, but it could happen. It looks like that both clans, Pro Kings and Forge Force Gaming, are quite equal in skill. And that's awesome. You know, I just hosted a tournament, Gold Platinum, and those games were really, really good. You wouldn't imagine how good those games were. Of course, some were a bit scrappy and such, but if you have similar skill level and some action, games are just good. So no matter which skill you have, if it's equal, then it's exciting. And that's just what this clan war is, exciting. Certain is wondering if he would have been fine killing the Nexus. No. The Nexus is 400 minerals, that's nice, yes. It would have delayed the attack potentially or give you a bit more time, but... Meh. I think the counter repair was missing from the SCVs. and then moving out with not getting the war prison. That was something. Okay, I need to open up Frost. And then I invite him to the game and promote him to the lobby host. Okay, awesome. 19 viewer, thank you all so much for tuning in to today's cast of this Clan War. Awesome. 19 people. I really do appreciate that you are listening to my voice. If my voice is beautiful or not, I don't know. That's up to you to decide. But yeah. Nice. A very nice Clan War so far. We might just have a TVT on Frost. Okay, this one. No, wait. TVC. CVP! Okay. So, a TVT shaping into a PVC. Good, good, good. Both players are ready. Wishing both good luck. Have fun. Awesome. And here we are. Come on. Game number 3 in this clan war, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it should be game number 3. Spawning in the bottom left position of Frost Leather Edition as the Teal Protoss playing for Forged Force Gaming, it is Buff. And his opponent, the orange Zerg spawning in the top right position of Frost Leather Edition playing for Pro Kings, it is the orange Zerg Mafiata. Okay, and it is cross position. This is very important to mention. It is Frost cross position. And what that means is this game could go very long, potentially. I don't know who you would favor on these spawning positions. Please, if you have any knowledge about PVC on Frost, tell me who normally is favored in on those spawning positions and why. I'm willing to learn out of you. If you know it, please let me know. The probe so far is scouting around, and look at that, only scouting for the creep. Awesome, not wasting any time. That is high level play right here, right now, today. Both Buff versus Mafiata. And we have Hatch Gas Pool against a fairly early Nexus. It wasn't Nexus first, but standard opening. And Mafiata so far not knowing where the opponent is. The overlords will confirm where both Buff didn't spawn, so that's fine. And there's the probe, scouting around, sees everything. Dum 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 dum. And the overlords don't scout anything. A really early third base, in my opinion. Really early. But okay, I think that's fine. Oh, we do see the Twilight Council out already. So this could mean blink, adapt, or maybe even DTs. I don't think it will be DTs, to be honest, but it could be the case here. So with the early third command center hatchery, of course, there's the robotics. Okay. You just might see Buff going for some aggression to punish this. Potentially. We will see. For now, the Adept is hunting a Zergling, finds a Queen, and. Oh! taking some shield damage here. Shade scouts a lot. Gets cancelled. And is now angry on the hedge. Why would you do that? Don't be so mean. The hedge didn't do anything to you. And there we have it. Resonating glaives. But for Mafiata, speedlings, and speed for the overlords. And I like this. Speed for the overlord is such a good and quite cheap upgrade. So if you want to have later drops, bane drops, speedling drops, queen drops even. This upgrade is so important. But also against Phoenix to get your overlords into safety again. It's really nice. There are the speedlings just scouting around, losing one of those, which is fine. And I would say, as Mafiati, you want to have one circling right here to see if there's any move out, one circling here, one circling right there, one at this bridge, one at this bridge, and grab the watchtowers. And then you see basically everything buff can do. But Mafiata not doing this. Man, I should coach those guys. just kidding. We see a roach one out of Mafiata, which can definitely help against adepts. How many gates are there? So far I see only 4 gates, but there is the DT shrine, uh-oh, and still no lair tag, and no scout at all as well. Ah, the overlord sees the DT shrine. Click it, confirm. Ah, you see it! It is in vision, however. I just think this base might be so bad. Where's the warp prison? Oh yeah, and the warp prison will be ready to warp in DT soon. There are no spores at all. This is checkmate. Basically, this is checkmate. The roaches are nice, but there's the warp prison. You see it! You see the warp prison! Come on, you see the Dark Templar Shrine as well. But it looks like Mafiata is too busy working against those adepts, and there's the DT warp, and 4 DTs at a time. Oh wow. And no detection at all. And the slicing will begin right now. Buff going for the hatchery here. Okay. That's okay. The warp prism survives. And there is... Okay. So the main base will be dead, which will mean the pool might just die. I would kill the pool. Kill the creep, yes, nice. Then kill the pool. Or maybe just go out of there and evac your DTs, which is fine as well. But those DTs did not deal... Well, they dealt quite some damage, yes. But I thought they would do way more. Interesting location to morph the lair. Some zerglings attacking here, getting a probe or two, being a bit annoying. Actually, they find quite some damage, forcing a photon overcharge. That's not too bad. Ah! Doesn't get the probe. That's sad. Where are the DTs? Back in the warp prison again, flying around, having a good time. Nice. Okay, buff, getting some upgrades here, plus 1 attack and blink, and got some sentries. But it looks like the game will slow down for now. But, oh, did he just... Okay, the DT's morphing, merging into Archons, into Overlords. That would be so stupid. Just imagine DT's can merge into Overlords. Woo! Why would you ever do that? Why would you ever do that? We just saw 3 additional gateways coming down, so now we are on 7 gates for buff. He could go up to 8, I think. And eventually he might go into double robotics, but he also could just choose to go for Stargate play himself as well. We will see later for sure. Mafiata going into a 4th base on 37 drones. That's insane! You need to drone! What's with your income? I mean, now it's looking okay. Those 22 zerglings could have been 11 drones. You need to drone up! But, yeah, with the attack coming, he needs the units as well. That's the big problem. Mafiata can't really drone up. 7 gates. So strong. Blink, plus 1. Buff will find a very nice timing. And I have not much hope for Mafiata. The spread, however, of this army is incredible, but will it be enough? It's off creep. 20 more Zerglings, yes, where's the Overseer? There's only one Overseer. If this Overseer dies, those Dark Templar... Oh, they just moved into Archons. Okay, never mind. Changeling gets sniped, killed, whatever, okay. Mafiata on 40 drones. In a long run, he won't be able to hold on for a long time, but very good surround, look at that. The Archons killing their own force fields? But oh wow, those force fields, those were so good. Aggressive blink forward, nice whirlwind in the back. I just think Buff got it. The firepower of Fortress was just too much. Buff wins this game number 3. Wow, so that means Forge Force Gaming gets ahead in this Clan War. Well played, very well played. Very well played. Okay, so we are on match point already. Game number 4. Yes, game number 4 is coming next. And that means if Forged Force Gaming wins this, they win the Clan War. However, if Pro Kings wins, then we might go into Ace Match. Well, we will go into Ace Match if we win now the next game. I would love to see game number 5, to be honest. That would be really nice. So let's all hope, okay? Let's all hope for game number 5. Come on, game number 5! Oh no, not this map. Not this map. Oh no. Oh no. Oh wow. Okay. Oh wow. Oh no. Oh wow. Oh wow. Okay. Okay, TVC, I think, will be the next game. And it will be on Tarzan Station. And that will be so wild. Okay. Okay. Okay, we're loading into this game, game number 4. Wow, today I'm not losing with the overlay. So far, that's awesome. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, game number 4 of this best of 5, as we have spawning as the Blue Terran playing for Forged Force Gaming in the bottom rightish position of Tarzan Station Ladder Edition, it is Gamer Richie! Woo! And he's playing against the Red Zerg in the top leftish position of Darzan Station, playing for Pro Kings. It is Cheese Legs! Okay. This map, TVC, oh my goodness. And Cheese Legs going for the gold base. Going for the gold base. Okay, we have the gold base. Okay. And there's the SCV scout. Potentially. Maybe. I haven't seen much of Gamerichi these days, sadly. But I know he's a damn good player. And he loves to stim himself to win. So he might see some crazy stim action. Confirming the gold hedge. Scouting with the SCV. Gas being taken. Overlord scouting around. So far, only standard openings. But let me tell you one thing. On Dozen Station, games can go wild really fast. This could escalate so quick. There are the back rocks here, back rocks there. If you take your own back rocks out, then you can go here as well. There are gold bases, small pathways. This Anak is also here. Anak. Ooh, what was that? What was that? Oh, nice. Anak. There's Anak. Double Anak. Anak OP. And there's the Reaper. And Reaper just crosses the double Anak line and confirms the completion of the hatchery. Okay. Will the Reaper get on a circling? That would be nice for Gamerichi. So far it's looking very good. Gets a kill. Just need to get out before the Queen pops. Gets maybe another circling. Nice micro. Very nice micro. And behind that, factory and the refinery as well. Nice grenade. Doesn't quite hit the Queen. And already Cheese Legs working on those rocks. Scouting for those rocks, scouting for those rocks. So Cheese Legs knows where to park his overlords. Yeah. Another barracks. Ooh! Small mistakes. Oversaturating on this gas. Now he fixes it. A Widow Mine, however. That's interesting. And morphing our orbital command. Ooh, two base. Okay, two base for Cheese Legs. He's morphing the lair. And so far, Gamerichi does not know it's coming. He also does know that there's no third base, so basically he knows not a whole lot so far. I do like that Gamerichi is closing this ramp with supply depots. He doesn't know about the rocks right here, which could be dangerous, but for now it's okay. He's being very annoying with the Reaper. Getting a drone here maybe! Wow, so close! I like the Reaper grenades here. That's a very interesting position for a Reaper grenade, but it finds some damage. Drops going out, middle mine with six marines, and yeah, so far nothing crazy is going on. But there's of course the Spire 2 base. On that map you hardly any see Nidus play, so Spire should be fine. And Spire is good against tanks and medivacs. Not so good against this, however. Oh yeah, this middle mine is in a very good position. Might just find a massive hit! Ooh! That could have gone way worse for both players. But okay. I would say they have tried quite equally. However, look at Gamerichi. He lost no units so far. No units! Yeah, the Widowmine goes down. Okay, now he lost a unit. But still, so far, up until the 5-minute mark, not losing any units? That's impressive. I mean, and he was constantly dealing damage with the Reaper. And with the drop now, so that's fine. Oh, I love this changeling. It won't get in because the depot wall is ready. Gamerichi just might wanna repair the medivac. Oh, nice with the tank killing creep. That's also a smart move. The tank one-shots creep tumor because they don't have any armor. Look at that. He's going a little bit forward. Oh, if he scans now. Oh, he will lose the tank. There's no way to save the tank, is there? Wow, but still the tank might just go down. Oh, but wow, impressive rescue attempt there out of Gamerucci. And behind that we see Cheeselegs going for another base, which he definitely needs to take. Killing a supply depot is good, so Gamerucci needs to do to get another one down. And those Mutalists, yeah, they didn't find the massive damage, but so far they are paying off. Oh, and this Medivac is still not healed up. You need to repair your units, Gamerucci. You need to do this. Yeah, there you go. There's the SCV. Always repair... What? There you go. Always repair your units. You know, if you can heal up by your units, then you definitely should care for your mechanical units as well. Do it. It's good. It pays off. Ah, cheese legs. Maybe you could get... Oh, the attack on the barracks! Gamerucci misclicking there, almost killing his own barracks. He needs to repair it. Oh, wow, pulling so many SCVs. I think that's a huge overreaction here. And Cheeselex is finding some damage. Yeah, Cheeselex is doing a lot of damage here. But now, Gamerucci had enough. He's like, okay, I'm moving out. Screw those Mutalists. I don't care. But is this the right move? What will Cheeselex do? Will he go back? He needs to defend. Oh, massive Banelings, but... Tanks are very good against slow banes. The Marines are so heavily clumped up. The Mutal is coming from the back. And it's looking... Wow! Very good for Gamerucci here. I thought the Banelings would do you more damage, but... Now... The Widowmine dealing friendly fire! But still... This small force might just be enough. Where are the Queens? There are only two queens in this game and five Mutalists now. Cheeselex is in so much trouble. He's morphing some emergency banings, but speed for the banings is not ready. However, 1-1 will finish up soon. The Mutalists might just find some damage here. Oh, they don't get the medivac. So close. 1-1 does finish up. And Gamerucci is still on two bases. He's finally getting his command center. Oh, what? Wow, that Widowmine. Wow, awesome splits here out of Gamerucci, and I think this could be game ending. It's so close. Can Cheeselex hold on? He's using a Mutalist now, trading them against the Marines, but it is not enough. Gamerucci winning game number 4, and with that, I would say he gets the win in this Clan War. First team, Forge Force Gaming, congratulations, well played. Oh wow. So I think... I think that's it. Okay, with that said, I end the stream right now. Thank you so much for watching. It was a very intense clan war. And we just might see us the next time again. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye.